Three great film endings, Maytime, Waterloo Bridge, and The Student Prince, and their curious link with what is revealed concerning the eternal love of man and woman in the early chapters of the book of Genesis. In the history of film making, there are hardly any more heart-wrenching endings than those of the three films just mentioned, and which endings will be shown here in this video. Some viewers have described these films as the saddest ever seen, while others take a completely different viewpoint, seeing in the sadness an even greater joy. And that joy is the hope that the couple, the main actor and actress in the films, will meet again. No matter what they have gone through, this hope cannot be taken from them. Curiously, these films present the same eternal love described in the early chapters of Genesis concerning several chosen couples, husbands and wives, from the time of Adam and Eve up to Abraham and Sarah. However, there is one significant difference. Whereas the films are merely fictional, the love described in the early chapters of Genesis is real. In other words, what each couple in the three films had hoped to find was in fact given as a blessing by God to several chosen couples described in the book of Genesis, where human love had the divine stamp of God written upon it. We might say more about this later, but first let us look at these three great film endings. Before each ending is shown, a summary of the storyline will be shown on the screen. Please use the pause button as required. The first film ending, Maytime.
Oh, you.
The second film ending, Waterloo Bridge.
I've never loved anyone else. I never shall. That's the truth, Roy. I never shall.
And the third film ending, The Student Prince.
Kathy.
Carl. What are you doing here?
I'm on my way to Nordhausen. I'm going to be married.
Yes, I know it was in the papers. That's the way it should be. I never thought I'd see you again.
I told you I'd come back.
Yes, you did. That was when you were a student here. We lived in the same world.
It's all the world I ever wanted. And we nearly got away. Remember the night of the carnival?
Yes, I remember. Oh, it was a wonderful dream.
Now it's over. Everything's different.
Nothing has really changed here. Nothing except you and me. You're a king now.
I still love you, Kathy. I always will. And you?
No matter whatever happens, that will never change.
My only love.
Your first love.
Goodbye, Kathy.
Goodbye, Your Majesty.
Gaudiamus. Let us rejoice while we are young.
As mentioned earlier, these three great film endings, although fictional, address that question central to the heart of every human being, a question which St. John Paul II also addressed in his study entitled The Theology of the Body, which is, can I find that person in this life whom I might call my other self, a person providentially chosen for another, so as to make each person complete, as the three films indicate. There is no need here to debate the question as to whether the arranged marriages in two of the three films, that is, the arranged marriages of Nikolai and Marcia in Maytime and Prince Carl and Princess Joanna in The Student Prince, might have been real or valid in the eyes of God, but rather we should highlight the main point which is made so well in the films, and that is that there is this other self. Even if things are not fulfilled now and darkness may lie all around, there is one thing that cannot be taken away from those who truly love, which is the hope of being united together again. Each of the film endings hints towards this. What is even more interesting, however, is that what is so well depicted fictionally in the three films, the providential coming together of each couple, was in fact something that graced our world and was actually experienced by several chosen couples whom God had united together in the beginning, as found written in the early chapters of the book of Genesis. For what is described there in those early chapters, and which appears to be the intentional sense of the inspired author, whom tradition holds to be Moses, is that from the time of Adam and Eve up to Abraham and Sarah, a considerable number of years later, marriage was so special in the eyes of God that for several chosen couples, each husband and wife truly regarded each other as their other self. This unique state of marriage gifted by God, which was subsequently lost, with the two being of one body, is examined in considerable detail in the recently uploaded series of videos on YouTube entitled Marriage in the Early Chapters of Genesis. This series of videos may also be accessed on the website www.paraclete.ie. A brief summary of the main points proposed in this series of videos now follows.
It is proposed in this series of talks that the inspired author of Genesis wishes us to see that the special manner in which Eve was created for Adam by God, being of one body, she was formed from his side, continued on, albeit in the fallen state, for a number of other blessed couples up to the time of Abraham, at which time it ended. While this is an extraordinary statement to make, that Adam was not the only man who was graced with his wife being formed from his side, but that it carried on for further generations of men until the time of Abraham, albeit passed on in the fallen state of being subject to concupiscence and death. There is, however, it is proposed, overwhelming evidence in the book of Genesis to support this. This series of talks will explore this evidence in Scripture.
In simple terms, it might be said that what will be proposed in this series of talks is that from the creation of Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden up to the time of Abraham and Sarah, something very special concerning the love of a husband for his wife is described in the Bible as a gift from God, for the two were truly formed from the beginning as one body. This series of talks will examine the biblical evidence for this.
Before we proceed with the introduction to these talks, we might first take note of Michelangelo's painting in the Sistine Chapel. This revered artist's painting depicts for us what will be proposed in this series of talks. In his painting, Eve, see God's left hand, is already in the mind of God before Adam was created. For every male, God has predestined a unique female, and for every female, a male.
And so, the couples providentially brought together in each of the three films, whom it might be said that God meant for one another, describes fictionally something that actually graced our world in the beginning. For in the book of Genesis, something most precious is described concerning the love of man and woman from the time of Adam and Eve up to Abraham and Sarah, what might be described as a legacy of the Garden of Eden. It was this that Christ restored on Mount Calvary in the blood and water which flowed from his side, which both St. John Chrysostom and St. Augustine described as Eve coming or flowing from the side of Adam. The Garden of Eden has been reopened for us, in which each bride and groom may now see each other as their other self.